We've got the rhythm, we've got the cool, and of course, we've got the youth. Yes. There's only one reason y'all keep coming back, and it is because you know in your heart of hearts that we are the baddest gang to ever do it on Nigerian TV. Agree with yourself?
Yes, where else can you find all the laugh, good music, and good vibe and entertainment we bring to you every day of the week?
Mm-hmm. Wait. Are you really trying to think about the answer to that question? Please don't bother, because there is no competition, guys. The bragging that we do here on Wednesdays is on a different level, but I love it. Now, welcome to the countdown edition of the show, people.
Yeah.
You can look up us on socials. Our handles are on IG and Twitter at TVC Connect. And of course on Facebook, we're at facebook.com/TVC Connect. Now, if you're wondering, my name is Amanda Dara, and today I'm feeling gangster, so what can you call me? You tell me today. AD?
Mandy.
You can call me AD.
Mandy.
No, Mandy is too mushy.
You can call me AD.
Yeah, AD.
All right.
Yeah, AD for sure.
AD
yeah.
for sure.
That works.
And of course, ladies and gentlemen, my name doesn't change. This is Royal Highness and His Blindness. I go by the name King OJ. Yes, boy, you can call me OJ. That's where it is. It is where
it's
it is.
The shade, but it's all right.
All right, guys, my name is Faladile, and like I always say, welcome aboard. All right, so guys, we have so much in store for you today. Let's talk about it. Mm-hmm. Here's what you can look forward to on today's show. There is entertainment news coming up very, very soon. Then, of course, celebrity birthday shout outs. Then there will be Rewind, where you get a quick history lesson of today in entertainment history. And of course, Woman Crush Wednesday.
And then, of course, there will be some Tweetville savagery and humor later.
Then it's time for Daily Top 5, where we'll be taking a look at 5.
Let's keep you posted on that one.
You guys should watch out for that
Yeah.
one. And of course, later on the show, one of us will do some venting on the Chewy Top segment.
Of course, then you get a quick recap of all that you might have missed in the news. Now, right after that, it'll be time to check out all the songs that are the rave of the moment on, wait for it, the East Flash Top 10 Countdown. Hey. Yes.
All right, guys, let's get it moving already. We'll be back after this break. Don't go anywhere. Greatness. Skip it. Jason, on the in the whip. Everything just little. Fresh. Go. That's how stars do.
Sir, sorry, sir. How do stars do?
Like I do.
Ice on my neck, ice on my wrist, you know. That's how I do. If you ain't talking money, please don't call me for a show. That's how I do. 10 million for a show. That's how I do. Never, oh, never to be caught on fresh. Okay. That's how I do. That's how I do. That's how I do. Haraku, how do I do? Like I do. That's how I do. Always dripping with swag. I pull up in a white Lambo with my Dura, come here Rambo. Danny, I be the one I be a cool. Tabatiri, me, go go on my shilaku. Star don't let you talk too much. Star let you keep it cool. That's how Star do. But if you vex Star, oh, Star go give you 2 punch to play. I'm a superstar, liar. Ice on my neck, ice on my wrist, you know. That's how I do. If you ain't talking money, please don't call me for a show. That's how I do. 10 million for a show. That's how I do. Never, oh, never to be caught on fresh. Okay. That's how I do. That's how I do. That's how I do. Haraku, how do I do? Like I do. That's how I do. Middle finger, star where I brother and nigga. Ask Ricky baby, that's my nigga. Mori emojiga, enemies in middle finger, star where I brother and nigga. Ask Ricky baby, that's my nigga. What you really want from me? Stars don't do peer, only NSC. 5 bitches in my Mercedes, ain't love it, star the collector say. What you really want from me? Stars don't do peer, only NSC. 5 bitches in my Mercedes, ain't love it, star the collector say. Okay. That's how star do. That's how star do. That's how star do. Haraku, how do star do?
do. See the swag in my shaku. Me repeating my bass is a taboo. It's not me you will cash with a balu. Even if my leg work is scano. That's how star do. She see wood game, she say that's bamboo. We don't really used to do overkaku. Don't bother checking price on the tag. Grab two in the back in my bathroom. In the glove compartment of my car too. Anytime that you say you want to pass through. Anything you see there, I dash you. This nice in the attitude. It's not just here in Gantan too.
What?
Go show you where it's only can school. So for one more, you can be careful. Be careful, be careful.
Ice on my neck, ice on my wrist, you know. That's how start do. If you ain't talking money, please don't call me for a show. That's how start do. 10 million, 10 million for a show. That's how start do. Never, oh, never to be caught on fresh.
Okay.
That's how start do.
Swaps.
That's how start do. I walk on like a Gucci, I walk on like a Fendi, I walk on like Ceruti, give me your like it. I walk on like a Gucci, I walk on like Ferrari, I walk on like designer, give me Fernand. Femi, Femi, no.
And tunes.
There was something really cool. I'm just moving away from that.
Yeah.
You're alone today, my love. There was something really cool she did at the Cardi B show.
Yeah, yeah,
that
I talked about it yesterday.
Yeah.
Amazing performer. I would love to see Niniola do it again. You know, her songs, like the same rhythm, the same production, that Afro House sound. Mm-hmm. And yeah, she just kept on performing from one song
that
to the other.
Again.
Straight beat, straight take. I enjoyed everything.
And she threw stuff.
Well, it's Nene Olano. Okay. You got a lover.
Or underwear.
What stuff does she
wear? Underwear.
Oh, underwear. Oh, that's nice. Very we interesting. Sure. Yeah. Well, we love her, right?
Definitely.
I don't know, guys. It's time for entertainment news. Now, the first story on our list is Terry G pleads for another chance. Nigerian singer and producer Terry G is pleading with his baby mama, Mimi Omoregbe, to forgive him for all the wrong he has done. He took to his Instagram page to issue his public apology, saying, and I'm quoting, "Sometimes there's simply no words that can adequately express the depth of a person's feelings that are plagued by regrets, guilt, and sadness for a wrong done. I want to tell you I'm sorry 1,000 times, but that can't undo what has been done or ease the pain in your heart. I totally deserve all the anger and the resentment from you. You are the nicest person any sane man would want to have as a part of them in this thing called life. Your calmness, niceness, understanding is unbeatable. How and why I did not think of moments you might get really hurt and walk away without a word. Your silence is killing. I am full of regrets. Please, Coco Mims, I know I don't have the right to ask anything from you when I've offended you, but if you can find it in your heart to forgive me and give me another opportunity to prove to you how much I love you and a chance to make your future a happier one with more laughters and few tears. It is, however, not clear what transpired to warrant this public apology, but we're all in this, right? So in case you do not know, Terry G and Mimi have a 7-year-old son together, and he posted this on his Instagram. What do you guys think about this?
Mama, don't mess up. But this is in fact, like... this is my theory. I feel like, I mean, I want to say maybe he cheated, but I don't know, he could have messed up in any other way, other ways, yes. And, it's to come publicly. I feel like it kind of makes me look like a bad person if you're publicly apologizing and then I don't forgive you. You've put it out there. Forgive this guy now. Like, how far? But I don't know what he did, but he's clearly sorry, and I hope that this isn't just for show. Like, I hope he's really making moves off camera.
That's what I was
going to
say. How do you know he's clearly sorry? Because he puts it on Instagram. Right. But then it's a big step. It's a huge step for him to go public about it. He must have definitely done, like,
messed up big time.
Like, you know when you block someone or WhatsApp to Instagram? Like, you cut them off. Even the email address, you're like, delete it.
I mean, maybe that's what happened. Maybe she has blocked him everywhere. So that's how... on Instagram, oh, how mess you? Help me, Ben Coco.
But then I have to say that, you know, sometimes I feel like, you know, especially with celebrities, musicians in particular, it just feels like, oh, women will come and go. I'm the one who is the hot cake. I'm the desirable one. So sometimes these things are wake-up calls that these women that are with you are putting... You know, putting up with all of this doesn't mean you should take them for granted. Yeah, so I'm happy that he's coming out to be responsible about it. You know, it reminds me of a Cardi B Offset
situation.
Yeah. Went on stage to even apologize. I like this. I love this move.
You like it, yeah? Can you do it?
Yes, I can.
Because I know you like to keep your life
very private.
But if you messed up, would you come on Instagram? Of course not. Hell, you post hell. On Instagram once a year.
I don't think you have done a very huge mess up.
On social media?
Mess up. Like, you don't know what
to do. Hell no.
Like, huge.
I'm not that guy, Amanda.
I'm not that guy.
So how do you bring your family members?
No, like, I would keep off camera, off social media. I would keep doing everything. If I need to send flowers, well, I'm not a guy. But if I need to send lunch, if I need to send whatever I need to send, I like to do my thing.
Plane tickets.
But that's just because... I'm a very private person, but if I wasn't, I see how I could.
Because I feel like sometimes I feel like she might feel if you're doing all of this in private, it's not
push
enough.
It out.
You know, especially because he's a huge influence out there.
Yeah.
You know, when Tubaba also came and did his own apology, these things it's a thing for them because they're already huge names in the industry. So it's not like the same with a normal person who is maybe not on TV or doesn't
like
have,
me.
No, you're not. Yeah, King OG.
Moving on.
So, moving on though, we're really happy that he came out
to
apologize. Well done.
All right, moving on to the next story. French Montana puts on bed rest after being hospitalized. Yes, Moroccan-American rapper French Montana has been released from the hospital after he had health complications, which led to an elevated heart rate due to strenuous activities. According to sources, the rapper has been on bed rest for the next 30 days, and he has been told not to walk, travel, exercise, party, or even perform for the next 1 month. Yes, despite the strict warning, French Montana was recently spotted out in a restaurant having dinner with fellow artist Megan Thee Stallion. Yes, if you will recall, last month French Montana caused a scare when news broke that he was rushed to the hospital after an emergency phone call that was made from his residence. So French Montana is back.
Yeah.
And they've told him not to. Yeah. And they've told him not to do.
They didn't disclose what happened to him. I think it was.
Yeah, heart rate, strain, stomach pain, and everything.
Yeah.
So right now, this festive season that you're supposed to be cashing out, your doctor is telling you
your health is more important.
Rest. Honestly, that's what I wanted to say.
Because
I mean,
he might look at it if he has looked at it in retrospect. If you don't have the health to even perform, then what's the point?
Yeah.
If you pass out and die, then what's the point? So it's good that he should stick to his doctor's orders on that one.
Yeah, for sure. And I remember, I think it was Whiskey who did this. Was it in December or January?
Yeah. Whiskey did this like 2 years ago. Yeah, then Techno did
last
year.
Was it December or January that he did it? It was one of those seasons, and it's like, I'm off for a while.
It's like, no, did it last year?
Yes,
too.
And it's important to take time, like you said, to take care of your health. I know bed rest can be quite, I haven't had to go through it, but I know people, I know pregnant women who have gone through it, for example, and, you know, maybe because it's a really delicate situation with your pregnancy, so you have to stay on bed rest. I know someone who had like 6 months, and so he just has a month, but I can imagine how annoying, because I'm very restless. Like, I like to be up and down and getting up to stuff, so I can imagine how annoying it must be. But look, just stick to the orders and take care of yourself.
This
health
thing
as well
is another wake-up call for all of us in the entertainment industry, and all of us are working hard. You people that you are doing 7 to 11 p.m. work.
Going to Akure, then Abuja, then Dubai.
No, but for real though, that's what I said.
For us. Okay, man.
All of us.
Yeah.
I included myself. Because it just feels like, we guys hustle, we guys do this. I'm the one hustling. Like, if you tell me that there's one job at 12.
Yep.
I'm almost there.
Yep.
If the money is right. But basically, I'm just trying to say that you have to take care of your health. You have to eat right. You have to diet right. You have to exercise right. Like, I paid for the gym. Again,
Amanda just went a few days.
Yeah, I think two days. Because we saw one video. Anyway, moving on from people who don't stick to their gym routines. Amanda, okay. We love you. It feels like we're coming for you today, Abby.
Yeah, but it's fine.
It's all good.
It's all good. There's still love up here.
All right, guys, moving on to our final story. Kel Mitchell becomes a licensed pastor. American actor, stand-up comedian Kel Mitchell of the Kenan and Kel fame is now a licensed pastor, apparently. He made this known when he shared pictures of his induction with the caption, "Officially became a licensed pastor last weekend. Blessed and thankful for my at Spirit Food family, and thank you, Pastor Ziegler, for seeing the calling of God on my life and trusting me with your youth department." # Soulful Sunday, # All God. Well, this news is not shocking to some, as Kel has been working in ministry for many years now, according to the website for Spirit Food Christian Center, where he's also a youth pastor. Okay, so really, really interesting.
I remember from Kenan and Kel.
Yes, I do. And it's so funny because Kenan is the one who has, I think he does Saturday Night Live.
Yes.
So he's also pretty still active with comedy. So I haven't really seen Kel get up to much lately. So it's nice to know that he's been doing God's work.
I'm excited about this one.
Second part to this, though, is I hope that he's like, I feel like since he's been in ministry for a while, it's like proper ministry. And I'm saying that because to get the license, like, you can get the license these days online, and that allows you to join people. So you see people who aren't very religious, but they have the license to join people. Exactly. So when he said licensed pastor, that was where my mind went. But I know he's also been in ministry for a while, so I think it's
and
like
a youth
proper
pastor.
Yeah, and a youth pastor.
I mean, I feel like a huge church like that would have made him go through a lot of training and a lot of, they would have been monitoring him for a long time.
Yeah.
But I'm very, very excited about this one because I feel, you know, it's a new, like a new dawn or a new era in the entertainment industry, where you see people who you're like, oh, you're a rapper, you're a comedian, rapper, that's Kanye West, you're a comedian, that's Kel. But here you are speaking about God's work, really burning for Christ and everything.
Justin Bieber.
I feel like Justin Bieber, like, what is
the
going?
Biebs.
What? Like, 2020 is going to be hot and heavy. King Gojie can just come up now and say,
hell no.
He's pastor.
Hell no.
Hell no. Heaven no.
Heaven no. Yeah. Okay, so let's do a quick one. A Nigerian musician.
You want to be mischievous now, and we're not here for it.
Oh, yeah.
A Nigerian musician, Davido being a pastor. Children of God, praise the Lord. OBO, if you know you want to make 30 billion, raise up.
Hallelujah.
So Davido,
praise
a pastor.
Jesus.
Whiskey.
Wow, you are the worst. Okay.
Whiskey chief imam.
That's all we can take on the news for today. Moving on to celebrity birthday shout-outs. Yes, it's time to find out which celebrities are celebrating their birthdays today. OJ, leave me alone, eh?
What?
Celebrating today.
But you, Davido, will shock you. Look at him. He's responsible. He's married. He has
children.
Three wives. What's next? What's next is a politician, so it will shock you.
Celebrating today are the following people. First on the list, Hailee Steinfeld. Yes, she's an American actress, singer and songwriter. And you might remember her for her breakthrough role as Mattie Ross in the drama Western film True Grit. And of course, she was nominated for that for an Academy Award. And of course, she turned 23 today. She was also in Pitch Perfect.
Yes. Yeah.
And a couple of other stuff that I can't remember. And I think she did some voicing for Spider-Man as well.
That is
so, yeah, really, really cool.
Happy birthday to her.
Happy birthday, Hailee.
She looks so good.
And she's so hot. Her eyes are everything.
She's so gorgeous.
Let's not even go
wow,
for that.
Happy birthday to her.
Let's not go for that.
Also celebrating today is Monique Angela Hicks, a.k.a. Monique. Yes, she's an American comedian and actress. And of course, she first gained fame as a member of the Queens of Comedy, as well as for her role as Nikki Parker.
Yay.
In the series The Parkers. I love her. And that she was such a nuisance.
Honestly.
She turns 52 today.
Oh,
and
wow.
Yeah, she was also in Fat Girls.
Yeah.
Fabulous. Thick,
I don't know why I just feel like if you trace her, she might be Nigerian.
Loki, yeah, because they even did some of that in Nigeria.
Yeah,
because
she has that vibe, that Nigerian woman vibe.
And she has
to
the fire as well.
And fire, of course, energy.
Can we talk about her recent drama?
No, don't talk about drama. It's her birthday, OJ.
Happy birthday, Monique.
There you go. Also celebrating today, American rapper and actor and activist as well. Mos Def is a year older as well, yes. AKA his real name, Yasin Bey, yes. And of course, he began his hip-hop career in 1994. He turns 46 today. He's also had some drama, but we ain't gonna go into that.
Because it's their birthday.
It's their birthday vibe.
And you can do how you like.
Abio, enjoy your life.
Enjoy yourself.
All right, well, happy birthday to all these talents and to everyone else celebrating out there today. Up next, a Rewind and Woman Crush Wednesday. Check them out.
Let's rewind. On this day in 1961, Elvis Presley's Blue Hawaii album goes number one and stays number one for 20 weeks.
This magic night of nights with you.
And in 1967, Guess Who's Coming to Dinner, directed by Stanley Kramer, starring Spencer Tracy, Sidney Poitier, and Katharine Hepburn, premieres in New York City.
Well, it's about time. I was wondering where you'd been. Mom, this is John.
Dr. Prentice, I'm so pleased to meet you.
I'm pleased to meet you, Mrs. Drayton.
And in 1980, finally, still on this day, Magnum P.I., starring Tom Selleck, premieres on CBS. And that's it on Rewind. It's Wednesday, and it's time for Our Woman Crush. And today, we'll be crushing on Oprah Gail Winfrey. She's an American billionaire media executive, actress, talk show host, television producer, entrepreneur, and philanthropist. She's best known for being the host of her own wildly popular program, The Oprah Winfrey Show, which aired for 25 seasons, that's from 1986 to 2011. In 2011, Winfrey launched her own TV network, the Oprah Winfrey Network. Oh. At age 6, Winfrey moved to an inner city neighborhood in Milwaukee, Wisconsin with her mother and then moved to Baltimore where she hosted People Are Talking. She was later recruited by Chicago TV station to host her own morning show. Winfrey, who later acknowledged her grandmother's influence, saying it was her who encouraged her to speak in public, giving her a sense of herself, is unarguably one of the most influential and one of the richest women in the United States.
So let's all just take this in for a moment.
Winfrey's success on television led to nationwide fame and a role in Steven Spielberg's 1985 film The Color Purple, for which she was nominated for an Academy Award for Best Supporting Actress.
I love Harper. God knows I do. But I kill him dead before I let him bleed.
With this, Oprah later went on to star in other movies like Selma, Wrinkle in Time, amongst others.
We the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union.
How many county judges in Alabama?
67.
Now here are five things you probably did not know about Oprah Winfrey.
Girl, you ought to bash Mr.'s head open and think about heaven later.
She was born into a very poor family. Her father, Vernon Winfrey, was a soldier, while her mother, Venita Lee, was a housemaid. Ooh. Now, fun fact, Oprah was actually born Oprah Gail Winfrey. The P and the R got switched. Thankfully, she corrected it. Now, Winfrey celebrated her 51st birthday by getting her ears pierced. As Oprah was growing up, other children made fun of the future queen of television because she was wearing overalls made from potato sacks. Now, guess what? She grew up to be the first African-American star to be on the cover of Vogue.
No, really, I'm just asking for them.
Now, here are a few of the many reasons why we love Oprah Winfrey, and she is our woman crush today.
Uji, you don't have respect.
We love you, Ops.
Did you hear what he said? He's like, hi, Gil.
Is she your mate? Hi, Ops.
Oprah. Your G. Oprah.
And what happened to Oprah?
Should I call...
Let her come on the show.
After the show.
As in, you won't call her on the show again?
No, I'll call her so that people can speak to her.
And let's speak to her now.
Oprah.
Yeah.
As in, I'm Gail. Sure everybody out there wants
Winfrey.
To hear.
Gail.
Right. Away from the lies over there, this is Studio Guys, where we bring you all the savagery, humor, and craziness social media has to offer in 5 minutes or less. Let's do this.
Let's go.
Alrighty, so this is a picture of AKA raising up his finger, even though some people have cancelled him on social media. No shade. And the caption is, who else has called someone before, hoping that the person wouldn't pick up just so that it will be on record that you called the person? This is my life. And this is my life because I don't like my phone calls. Like, I feel like...
Called you. Yes. Check it. Around 7:30.
I don't like calling. Like,
and
I
you're
don't,
just waiting like... Let it go.
I don't pick.
Like phone calls so that it goes on record that I returned your call or that I reached
honestly.
Out. So when you don't pick, I'm like, I don't even wait. You know, some people, it would have been ringing for like five times with you.
But for them,
it just rang once. I'm like, oops, I tried though. Moving on. Next week.
Everybody's on that table.
Everyone.
I swear.
Y'all are the worst. All right, at Eniola, who says, Cardi B is really that friend,
that friend
that your Nigerian parents warn you against because she's corrupt, in quotes. Mm. But after one visit to your home, they're like, what of Cardi? Is she not coming here again?
Yeah.
Like, I love it.
Cardi B.
I love it.
No, but we have to give it to Cardi B. Like, she made Nigeria look so interesting.
Yes.
I love her energy so much.
And we're just trying not to, like, fuel the Ghana-Nigeria
drama.
We couldn't... There are so many memes that came out of the Ghana-Nigeria drama.
Honestly.
I even saw a recent video that she was talking about it. I didn't know Nigeria and Ghana had fight.
With her nails, her
it's
nails
like
so
Puerto
long.
Rico.
And... I checked my itinerary.
Yeah.
And I'll be checking it.
Yeah.
And I didn't see no meet and greet. So I'll be chilling, eating kebab, you know, sipping my juice.
Also,
and you be there staring at me like I have shit on my eyes. So I'm like, this girl,
also,
love her.
She put up on her Insta story yesterday, missing Nigeria.
Nigeria. Exactly.
And there was no missing Ghana. But she now put up that girl that fake twerk on the floor.
Faladele, what are you trying to do here?
Right, let's go to the next
one. Let's
move on. All right, let's do it.
So you people are claiming Cardi B now. You see what Nigerian parents are doing? Cardi B.
Cardi B.
Cardi
B.
Mama Ayo.
Mama Kosta.
The Christian daughter Ayo Mide. Mama Ayo.
I mean, you are there with her though.
Yes,
Mama Culture. People are a mess. Right, Alex London tweeted, I'm going to stop posting my departure gate on IG before my flight takes off now. The way the plane was shaking this morning,
hey.
The Yoruba in me knows it had to be evil eye.
Honestly, your village.
Ojo, the eye of the world.
somebody followed me on Instagram the other day.
We're still that serious.
And
now.
The person's name was Your Village People. That's the handle. Honestly, there's not a community. So yeah. One has to be very watchful. Yeah. Because you can think it's a joke. But I, when I saw it, I blocked the person.
No, but
it's that serious.
Oh, Jay, serious.
Your Village People just start following you.
You know that low key, this is one of the reasons that I don't make my trips public. As in, my star, if me and my star and I travel together and she'll be doing this, I'm like, don't put me in that. Do not put me in that.
Apart from the fact that your village people, your village people are your people.
No, no, but apart from the fact that people say, where is the chocolate you brought back?
I don't That's know. True.
Okay,
also, I don't want the plane to shake.
But honestly.
But yeah. Why will your village people
Nah, I'm kidding. God pass them.
Why will your village people want your plane to shake?
Village people, you don't have to offend them.
No, they're your village people. They're your family.
No, they don't need
the
visa.
The problem is that they're not even using their witchcraft for good things. That's the problem. So it's your own life and destiny.
Village people. I'm not saying anything bad about you people.
They're not your relatives in the village necessarily, even though some relatives are evil. They're just that.
Okay, wait. We're getting too deep.
I'm not saying anything about you people.
This is just Sweetville, guys.
It's not Deepville.
It's not Deepville.
Moving on. All right. At the Naya tweeted, the perfume I want is 96K. Yeah. The wig I want is 145K.
Nice one.
The money I have is just 25K. And then Lekki replied, oh, the gun and mask you need is 5K.
Go and rob.
Because it's a robbery behavior.
Honestly.
How do you need almost 300K?
But the girls that are on this table, though, wow.
Amanda, are you on it?
At all, man.
Can you spend 145K on a wig?
I cut my coat according to size.
That's a good way to live.
But then a lot of girls like be wanting all this stuff for their birthdays, Christmas gifts, Valentine's Day gifts, this one, that one, but their money is not adding up.
And it's no problem if you want this. Like, because I one thing I've learned lately is don't judge people on how they spend their money. Mm. So it's no problem if you can afford to, you know, spend this on that or that.
If you have 225K or you have 325K, but then you have 25K.
But then, if you're going to hang this thing on a maga's neck, it's not fair. OJ. Prepare for that message from B. She gonna tell you she need a wig of 145K for Christmas.
Christmas gift.
You can't hear me.
Valentine's Day.
You can't increase my volume.
I can't even hear. I have a problem with Lekki, by the way, that said mask and gun is 5K. How does he know that?
Angle. All right, Irinia tweeted, my neighbor made a prank call to a friend with an unknown number saying, and I quote, your life is next on the list. We will find you. She kept crying like a baby. We laughed, as in the person was crying, right? And then she now came back. She's like, yesterday I heard she went to the village to handle the matter traditionally. And now my neighbor has been crying like a baby since.
You are talking about village people again.
What do you say about that?
You say something. Huh?
Shall I take you through it again?
It was a joke, man.
Yeah, but then people don't joke with
don't
their
joke
lives.
With stuff like
can
that.
You tell me I'm next on your list? Yeah. And cause Some people's
30 minutes prayer is, Father, Lord, all my enemies, you are now dead, pranking about that. That's a very serious one.
Village people are hello.
Right. I think that's all we have.
Oh, wow.
Yesterday.
By the way, I love your look.
Thanks, baby girl.
Oh, please. Police.
Let's take a minute.
You're being a hater.
Let's take a minute. Come, guys.
All right, guys.
Wow. Can I take you back?
Are you done?
No.
All right, guys. Yes, we are done with Tweetville. This vein is happening right here. Yes, we'll take a break now. And when we come back, it'll be time for Daily Top 5. Stay with us.
Fola Daily, what happened to you?
DJ Consequence featuring Mayoko, and it was quite a year of DJs featuring artists, so there was a lot of that this year. All right, guys, moving away from that, it is time for Daily Top 5.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Let's go. All right, guys, today we're going to be taking a look at 5 Nigerian artists with dual citizenship. Maybe you'll be inspired. So I don't know what you can do at this point, Sha. That's what I'm saying. I don't know what you can do at this point, Sha.
So, Japa.
No, even if you do, you have to live there for like years. But then maybe.
Canada, I think you have to live there for like 5 years or so.
So.
Don't do it illegally though, because these guys didn't. I think. All right, number one, Davido. Yes, Nigerian music star Davido was born in the United States. Yes, he was actually born in Atlanta, to be precise. And of course, we know that he then came back home. And of course, he grew up in Nigeria and did school here. I believe he did university here as well. So yeah, I know that, you know, he's quite. So he was born there, which is the way that I really would like to do it for my own children. Born them there and then bring them back. Here, back home. Yeah,
like I don't want to. Like if I was in London right now.
And then I think some of his children. Yeah. I'm not sure if all were born in the U.S. as well.
Mm. U.S. Haley.
Haley.
If I in London.
Yeah, UK. Yeah.
London. The UK. I don't know if Imade. I don't know if Imade.
Look, if you can afford to do it, man. Do it.
Japa.
Sorry. I'm not sure if this thing is about afford. It's just if you have the link.
No, what I mean, if you can afford to have your kids there, oh, that's what me I'm saying. I believe stay in your country. Look,
Nigeria is great.
Nigeria is home. And what I like about these guys is that they have the Nigerian passport and they have, you know, the abroad.
And they even, too. You don't even see him, Davido, really louding an American.
Yeah.
Yeah, you don't really see
But then
him
when
that.
He goes for an interview abroad, though, he turns on the American accent.
He'd be like,
could be risky.
You know, I've been making music, you know.
Yeah, since I was in. So, I grew up in the ATL. Yeah. I did this. Let's just move on.
Moving on, though. The second person on our list is Nato C. Now, this Nigerian rapper has made a mark on the music industry that can never be forgotten. Now, he was born in Texas, United States, and he made his return to Nigeria at an early age. I think with Nato C, you could actually see his somehow the Ote vibe.
His orientation is not from yet.
Yeah. And even though he came back at an early age, you just see that he has a very different way of thinking, different way of doing things. So somehow it affects you, I guess.
It's an vibe, yeah. Exposure is everything, honestly. Yes. It just puts you in a different position. And I think it's fantastic.
All right, number three on our list is Banky W. Yes, EME boss and music mogul Banky W was born in New York City, yes, United States, to Nigerian parents. Yes, his parents moved back to Nigeria when he was 5 years old.
In New York, Banky W was born.
Oh, wow, Amanda.
No, but and it's also nice. What I'm surprised about. I didn't know about it.
Oh, yeah, no. I know that. I know that I knew he had something to do with the States because I feel like his parents even are there right now. I think they live there.
Yeah.
Exactly. So I think there was a time where he went to visit them and he did a surprise. They didn't know he was coming home. So that was when I first knew that, he actually, like, there's a proper, you know, routine there. So, yeah.
So do you think all of these people that went there to coming back to do music, do you think if they were doing music there as a Nigerian, like what Rotimi is doing?
Oh, yeah, no, definitely. Even Rotimi
had to come back and he has gotten...
To be honest, I feel like the market is here for them, but that the security is there for them. So they can have like a getaways. It's just like best of both worlds.
Yes.
They're very lucky.
I think that's what I wanted to say. That ability to shuttle is fantastic. Fantastic.
All right. The fourth person on our list is Malik Berry. Famed singer and producer Malik Berry earns a spot on the list, having been born in South London.
Malik Berry.
That's another person that you know that today is Anote.
Yeah.
But this one, like, it's not even a surprise because he's fully, he's fully there and just graces us with his presence every now and then just to do music and come out. And he's really, like, I think he's really enjoying that best of both worlds. And I have to say, Nigeria has been very, very kind to him.
Yes.
Like, I mean, he had, I think it was 2017, where cleaned
2018,
cleaned like out. There was juice. There was. He was been calling. Let me know. Like, honestly, so many. He really did hit that year.
Oh, man, I think Nigeria is one country that actually embraces its culture and its people. Even though you're anywhere in the world, it's like we love you so much.
Yes, we're still fams. Was it Ben Bruce we were listening to the other day talking about Anthony Joshua?
Yeah. All right. The fifth person on our list is Ikechukwu. Nigerian rapper turned actor Ikechukwu was born in Manassas, Virginia, United States. And he released his debut album, Son of the Soil, in 2006 when he returned to Nigeria. And
singing it to everybody. My name is Ike Chukwu.
and he
was telling us he was the son of the soil.
Yeah, and he's also really enjoyed this.
You know, there's something that happens with some of these people. They have to really reinstate their identity.
I'm
like,
the son of the soil.
I am Nigerian. I am Igbo. So, I mean, Ike Chukwu is another person on that list.
And he's also really enjoyed this because he's no longer even just music. Now he's acting as well.
Yes.
So really, really nice. Alright guys, we will take a break now. Yes, that is it on Daily Top 5 in case you missed that. And yeah, we'll take a break now. We'll be back with a special guest. Yes, he's a fire producer and he actually has a song on the countdown. So you really don't want to miss out on who it is. Don't go anywhere. We'll be back, guys.
Yes, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We have super producer right here in the building. Yes, I can say it's controversial right about now. Yes, super talented producer, Produce Soko. And of course, the controversial song, Joro. Ladies and gentlemen, we have the boy from the North. North boy is in the building.
Welcome to the show, North
Thank
boy.
You. It's good to be here. Yeah, nice to be with you guys.
He added something to his intro because he calls himself the number one Afropop beat maker in Nigeria.
You saw that on my bio, nice.
Yeah, I did. Bragging rights.
Yes, I am.
All right, so welcome to the show.
Yeah, thank you.
been a bit of a dramatic year.
It's crazy.
Yeah. So tell us, before we get there, tell us about the year that you've had.
This year?
Yeah, because you said it's been crazy. So yeah. Talk about that experience.
Like, you know, it's been like an enlightening process for me. Mm. You know, like, I've learned a lot. Like, you know, most of the things we learn in life, we learn from the bad situations.
Right. So what bad situation happened? Okay.
See, you guys just emphasize the best.
Like, that was like
many bad situations happen. Like, yeah. Even in my family, like with my friends, like,
wow.
Like, you know, what's happening, it's like a thing in my life, not just about music.
Yeah. Oh, yeah?
Like, yeah, everything is changing in my life. Like,
you know, so. The reason why I'm so surprised to hear this is because I would have said that you were having a fantastic year. I mean, from Fever, Soko, Joro, Keys to the Kingdom, Tiwa Savage,
yeah.
Peruzzi song. Like, you've done so many big things this year, breaking every time on your Instagram, because I'm following him.
Album.
He's always like, thank you, God. Another number one, another hit, another streaming. Like,
it's been a crazy year. When you mean good crazy. But then, okay, let's talk about the bad situation.
Yeah, it's good,
because
good
you don't
and
want
bad.
Us to dwell
I want to start on the bad. I wanted to start with the bad.
Okay, so start on the bad. So, you know, there was a bit of drama on Twitter a while back, War of the Producers, and then there was the whole talk about Wizkid not paying you for Joro. So can
another lesson.
Eh? Sorry?
That was another lesson I learned.
Exactly. So can you tell us about what really happened, just as quickly as you can make it? Because we don't really want to...
Summary, because I already took an interview on that already, so exactly. Like, and everyone like, you know, like, well, it's just... The basic of thing is, you know, like, well, we work, I love working with him. He's very hardworking. Like, I never knew a human could be that hardworking.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I lived with him for 3 months. And, like, I'll be woken up 4 a.m., come to the studio.
Wow.
Wiz goes to the strip club, comes back to the studio. He goes to shows, comes back to the studio. I've never seen anybody work that hard before. So, I took that from him. But, like, we're working, but, you know. But anytime, when it comes to money, it's always an issue. So yeah, that was how the thing
It's always a fight when it comes to money.
Hmm.
Aside that, like, we have an energy.
Okay.
We have a power when we work. But, like, you know, life is beyond that. You know, like, it comes down to paying your bills, taking care of your family, making sure your brothers are okay and everything, you know? So, like, even if...
The industry has really moved to a place where producers are getting what they deserve now, or
yeah,
moving
exactly.
Closer.
Like,
the world
in generally.
Yes.
Wow. The world in general, you know? So, like, anytime I bring that up with him, it's always an issue. But, you know, I want to believe that he's working on that, because that's, like, a personal issue he has to work on himself.
Mm.
Yeah.
Okay, still talking about this issue right now. The song that caused all of this controversy is Joro. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Now you produce Joro.
Yes, of course.
Wizkid put it up on social media that song was produced by Killer Tunes.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
So, the song that came out that we're listening to right about now, was that a tweak to what you produce, or it's still the same thing you produced?
That's the original file. Everything there is mine.
Everything there is yours.
Yeah, everything is mine.
But is this the first time this is happening? Like, is this only with Joro? What about Fever? What about Soko? What about the other songs you've
but
done with
it? It did happen then, but he didn't bring it out to the open. It's something that, like, happened between us, like something that I observed that he's doing that. I know.
Not paying?
Yeah, no, not just not paying. Like, it's a lot. Like, I feel I've said so much about Wiz, like, I'm done with it. But, you know, like, I learned from him, and he's made a couple of mistakes with me.
Mm.
You know, that I feel that he will learn from eventually, and maybe we'll mend things up and we'll get back to work.
All right, so where do you guys stand now? Before we move on away from that,
okay.
Because we need to talk about your craft, because I think it's fantastic.
Yeah.
So, yeah, like, where do you and Wiz stand now? Obviously, he knows how you feel.
Mm.
And are you guys on good terms? Are you?
We're not talking. Presently, we're not talking. I'm not sending him beats. We're not talking. We've not talked. No, like, since the whole Twitter thing.
Yeah. Mm.
So, but if he reaches out to me, it will be based on business. My lawyer and my team will look into it and we'll work. It's based on business.
Yeah.
I like that you said that, because it's important to take stuff like that out of such experiences.
Yeah. Definitely.
You know, putting structure in place. So we're living together.
No, I believe I've learned. He has learned. Yeah. We should move on. There's no point.
What about your relationship with Killer Tunes now? Him taking credit for what you produce. Are you cool with Killer Tunes?
As
a producer.
Yeah, I posted, he dropped an EP recently. Bedouin and things. I posted that on my page. I'm cool with him. Mm. I don't have an issue with him.
Okay. But
yeah,
then,
I'm good. I don't want to keep him in mind. You know.
Oh yeah.
Like, even if, like, he doesn't reply my messages, he doesn't want to fuck with me. I'm sorry to using that on TV. Like, he doesn't want to have anything to do with me. So, but it's cool. Like,
Killer Tunes 2 doesn't talk to you?
He doesn't, like.
But let's talk about...
For no reason, man.
Let's talk about your
career. I don't care about that. Like, I don't
care
about...
Let's talk about your career, because I feel like we're going to get you too much in your feelings with all this drama and stuff. Let's talk about how, you know, even despite all the challenges and all the bad things that you've faced, you have had a very wonderful year. A very solid year.
You produced a whole lot of hits.
What would you say, what hits did you love producing the most?
All of it.
All of it.
It's been fun because me personally, I don't give out a beat that I don't love.
So which artist have you loved working with the most?
Wizkid.
Wow.
Of course. No, but like, no.
I'm not sentimental. I'm not being sentimental. I'm not the kind of person that airs to my feelings and all that. He's the best person I've worked with. Before I started talking about, I told you how hardworking he is and how I learned. But he's the best. He's the best person I've worked
about
with.
It.
Yeah. I think that's great. And is there anyone you haven't worked with that you would like to work with next year?
I'm already working with Rema, so...
Nice. I'm looking forward to that one, actually.
It's gonna be awesome.
I really, really like Joro. I talk about the instrumentals, like, that thing at the beginning. Oh, yeah, it gets
Do you know I played that for, like, 5 days before I made the beat?
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I kept on playing just
what
that.
What can I do with this thing?
No, I was enjoying it. I didn't want to make a beat with it. Mm. It was my friend that told me, hey, you should add drums to that. So I just added drums in, like, 30 minutes, and that was Joro.
Amazing. What? And it's been on our countdown for a while now. It was number one for a couple of weeks, I think about 3 weeks or so. Mm. And it's still on our countdown. That's how fantastic of a song it is. And we'll find out if it's still on the countdown today.
But before we let you go, how are you enjoying the recognition, though? Because you're one of the producers that people actually know. You're one of the people who is taking their name and building a brand out of it.
It's day and night. It's good and bad.
This good, like, and bad.
Yeah. Because you might enjoy it, but it gives a lot of anxiety. Like, there's a lot of design, a lot of pressure. Like, it makes it difficult to live with yourself.
Okay.
So can you, a quick one now, how much did you make from working with Beyonce on a project?
Love that question. Yeah,
they paid me, I think it was $5,000.
How much is that? I love that you answered.
Oh my gosh, thank you.
But that's for the beat, that's minus paperwork. That's without paperwork. In Naira, it's like 1.8 million, I think.
That's just for the beat alone.
That's for the beat. That's
but
the beat.
Of course, you know, royalties and stuff.
Yeah, everything is involved too. I'll start getting that from next year. I'm waiting for the numbers to pile.
Wow.
Even from Joro, Soko.
Congratulations.
Even from Soko, Joro, everything. Like, the numbers will start getting that from next year.
Fever did a solid number. Yeah. Like,
Fever is great.
Well done. Alrighty. Well, thank you so much for coming through North Boy.
And nice
it's so nice. The boy from the North is over is over in the Southwest, cashing out. But it's all good. It's all
before wrap up, do you have a project you're currently working on as a producer?
Okay, yeah. There's this I'm putting out a beat project presently. I put out Havana 1. I called the beat Havana 1. Havana 3. Mm. On my audio mark. So I'm gonna put out Havana 4 this Friday. It's Havana series. It consists of 5 beats. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna put that out. I'm also gonna be working with Bona next year. So
nice. Yeah. Oh yeah, I'm looking forward to that
one.
For sure. It's gonna be
big. Well done. I think you're super hardworking as well. Honestly. Nah,
this is my best.
Pushy,
like
pushy.
To clear stuff up, I use a lot of those kind of words. I'm not used to TV. I'm not used to TV, okay? But like
yeah, just
I think the motivation, I think Wiz was motivated to say Killer Tunes produce Joro because of the incident we had concerning the Damian Marley record. That was the last thing we had on Instagram. Cool. We're exchanging words. Like, he was threatening me. I was telling him, do your worst. Mm. Like, he was telling me, okay, when I come, you see what will happen. I said, okay, when you come, I want to see what will happen. So it's stuff like that. So like, he saw that, like, it was, everything was messed up, and he saw that I was gone, I was out. So he'll send his messages, and he went online. And since then, he's been like on my neck. Like, but I really wish that he would let it go. You get me? Like, because he's holding him back. It's holding him back.
Mm. Not you though.
Me, come on.
Okay. Right. Thank you so much for coming through. Not, but right. Don't go yet, man. Wait, okay. Wait. Thank you for coming through, and we wish you all the best in 2020.
Yeah, awesome.
It already sounds like it's going to be a good year, so
it's gonna be
all
good.
The best. All right, guys, this is where we draw the curtains on the first half of the show. Still to come, we have so much more. Yes, entertainment news recap, East West Top 10 Countdown, and a very, very special thing in store for you guys.
Yes.
But you don't want to miss it, so stick around, all right?
Yes, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, it's time for the second half of the show. Yes, and of course, Mrs. Arike is right here in the
building. Where have you been?
All my life.
She's our guest today. Hell no.
She's not, but
yeah,
she's had a long morning. I think road while and traffic and all that. But yeah, you're here.
And we're glad to have you.
I know, you've missed me.
Okay,
now.
Moving on, guys. Wow. Yes. Wow.
So far, we've brought you the news, Rewind, Sweetville, Daily Top 5, and of course, our guests. Now it's time to chew it up in a minute or less. One of us will rant about what's presently bugging her. Because I'm good.
What's your life problem? What's bothering you, babe?
You know, so I want to talk about this whole double standard thing. The conversation has been going on Twitter and it's crazy, and a lot of people have been misunderstanding the whole thing, saying that, you know, most celebrities are coming for Cardi B, but most of them are like, no, we're not upset with Cardi B, we love Cardi B, we're just not in support of the hypocrisy or whatever it is. But then this is what I have to say about it, and this is my rant. I feel like you don't have to use someone else as a standard for your own life. So if you're doing your own thing and you feel like people are judging you, people are gonna talk anyway. Mm-hmm. So let them keep talking. It doesn't make sense to me that you're not saying, one celebrity is in Nigeria, not this thing. Is Cardi B do you understand what I'm saying? Like, is that the yardstick for morality, who you are or what you're doing or whatever it is? So Cardi is Cardi. People love her the way she is. I'm sure that there's still some people out there still judging whatever it is that, you know, she's doing or she's done. And, you know, it's going to happen to you too. So say, okay, please, oh, I don't like when people judge me. Leave it at that. Don't come and say,
I beg to differ with that argument, because I'm a huge fan of Cardi B. I've been talking about her like for 1 week. Mm-hmm. But I do understand what Nigerians are saying, where they say it's hypocritical that some of the things that she's endorsing, she came to Nigeria with her attitude, with her cursing and everything, and we thought it was cute. Now, if a Tiwa Savage and another of our Nigerian artists did the same thing because that is their personality, we're going to have a huge issue with this. We're going to say, this is not our culture. This is not what you're supposed to be teaching to our youth. Even as much as you're trying to say, let someone be who they are, the truth is that if you're Nigerian, you do that, they will come for you worse than they will come for Cardi B.
Cardi B did not come up, we didn't know Cardi B to be a pastor or a motivational
Thank
speaker.
Thank you. Yes.
Cardi B is from the pole.
Thank you.
To the studio.
Thank you.
So that is what she is.
So my point again,
former stripper.
If anyone is coming for you, face them and say, Nigerians, leave my life alone. Don't say, oh, you're... Yeah, we already know that there's double standard and, you know, people are hypocrites. I mean, if I was even sung about it. But I don't think using someone else as...
No, but then people also... And I align with Amanda on this. People also have the problem with the fact that we saw her come here, go to the strip clubs and, you know, glorify it. And people, a lot of people talked about that. But if a Nigerian artist did that, or even the people that they are glorifying.
I wasn't like so hyped about that particular one, the strip club one. Right. But I like her energy in general.
I like her energy. But it's the same thing where people are saying, keep that same energy when one of us is doing it. And it's hard because also hard to get the same thing, because our culture doesn't, you know, celebrate that.
Yes.
And that's just the reality of it. Yes. So you can't expect that, you know, people will glorify that. But Cardi, we knew that, like OJ said,
that's what she is.
It's
not that you go there now. Cardi B will not go there and go on her Instagram page and be saying, oh, be great, to be great, motivational speaking. But if your Nigerian artist does that, what are you doing? You just left the strip club and you're doing motivational speaking.
I listen to Cardi B's rant, so it's very, very logical sometimes. You can learn a lot from her. Moving on.
From this long... Khadija B. She's part of us. Khadija
B.
Khadi.
Let's just do.
I think Choma B, actually.
Okay.
She wants to be Igbo.
All right. Well, moving on. It's time for a quick recap of the entertainment news.
Exactly. It is time for that. We told you that Terry G pleads for another chance with his baby mama.
And of course, we talked about this one. French Montana puts on bed rest after being hospitalized.
Mm-hmm. And then we told you that Kel Mitchell becomes a licensed pastor. Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm. Sorry, Rick, I was asking, which Nigerian artist do you think can switch and become a pastor and you'll be there for it?
Nigerian artist. Should I say Wizkid?
What? Why?
Yeah.
You know, hallelujah.
Yeah.
That would surprise me a whole lot. Like, I would be shocked.
Yeah.
It won't be bad, of course, as in glory to God. But yeah, like, that would just be surprising. Faladele is as her
pastor. Children of God in the building. Say Yaga!
Oh, Zlatan! Aye! Ekwariwo, aye!
No.
You asked the wrong person.
Yeah.
Honestly.
Ladies and gentlemen.
I'm not with you, babe.
I'm sorry.
Not at all.
But they asked me the question.
Okay, I'm sorry for that. I'm sorry. I'm very sorry. Yes, wow. Before we kick off with the countdown, we'll take a quick break. And when we come back, we'll be joined by a fellow Esplash host, Honeypot, and of course, the queen of the street, Ibukun Oluwa, for something very special. So stick around. Yes, sir.
All right, guys, we are back. Yes, and well, we told you earlier that when we come back, we're going to be having two of our fellow hosts joining us on the show. Yes, Honey Pot and the Queen of the Streets, IBK, are in the building. Yes, we dragged them down for today.
Please, what are we going to call today? Because it's not the gang. This is the gang.
The gang. All right, so of course, there's still the countdown coming, so you guys can hold on for that. But before we get into that, we're going to do this real quick. Okay, so we have something called Secret Santa, which we're going to be doing in the Christmas season on Christmas Day show. So you guys better watch out for that one.
Yeah.
And the box is back.
Ooh.
And we are going to be the evil box. We're going to be passing this around.
Is this evil this time around?
Yes, it's evil. It's always evil now. And we're going to be passing it around. And you each have to pick a name of a person who you're going to be gifting something.
On Christmas Day. Ooh, that's nice.
Let me pick first. I want to pick my name.
White.
Who is this?
I want to pick
my name. Who did this?
So make sure.
You have to pick yourself, actually.
I pick myself.
You'll give yourself a gift.
Okay.
So look up.
Cool, let me pick me.
Honeypot is not looking up.
Oh, wow. Let me pick me.
Ladies first.
Amanda, don't look down. Look up.
Okay. We're looking up. To the sky. So can I open it
now? Don't open it yet.
Don't open it. Okay. Great.
Please don't pick me.
Baby, I would like to pick you, though.
Oh.
Well,
Mrs. Arike,
you have to change your name. Come to do Arike Dimples.
No, because I went to show a bit on Monday and I saw Arike saying my husband.
Tell us what's happening.
Why are you acting quiet when we know that you're not okay on the street?
She's pretending to be normal. I don't understand.
That's the street, you know, go in the studio. So I'm kind of.
Oh, wow.
Is it different?
Do not
be. I better not be Arike. So is it time to open it yet?
I know, be Arike.
OJ.
Why did you open it now, honey?
Wow, I thought I were meant to.
OJ.
No, wait.
What are you really doing? OJ is cheating.
OJ, go back.
Okay, what is that?
Let's open it now.
All right.
OJ, why are you cheating?
Oh, wow.
Okay, so you're not supposed to announce who you got.
Really?
So, yeah.
Oh, that's your idea.
Really? Yes. Thank you so much.
Till.
Pass our box back.
Wow. So what am I doing with this name now?
Yeah, so you keep it and you get the person the gift. Aww. And we'll find out who you got and what you got them
Christmas.
On Christmas Day.
I want to twerk on the roof.
Yeah.
No, you can't, but you can twerk on up out of here.
Wow. Thank you guys for coming through.
Wow.
No.
Okay, thank you so much for coming all the way down.
Thank you.
Arike has to say something before she goes.
Like, what do you want me to say? Is this like a shout out or something?
you can't do a shout out. How do you feel being on the sets, on the couch?
It's kind of weird. I like to be like, you know,
ginger.
Exactly. But you guys look all prim and proper, so I have to.
Oh, really? This one's an normal look.
I know.
I know.
All right.
Thank you.
On that note,
before we let you go, can you just do small madness for us?
Small madness?
Yes. That is street madness.
Can I give you a microphone?
Small madness.
Yes, your microphone's straight.
Wow. Okay, today is not the day. Thank you guys so much for coming through. Right, guys, we'll go on a break now and we'll be back with the countdown, baby.
Yeah.
So don't go anywhere.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
We are back.
Back to four.
Yes, sir.
All right, guys, it is time for the top 10 countdown. And we have a brand new entry at number 10 spot. That is me sobbing OJ. yeah, boyfriend. By Zlatan. You know, I saw this video and I laughed. I was just laughing. I was like, wow, Zlatan, a counselor, really? And it is called yeah family planning or whatever it is. Yeah, family something, meeting or whatever. Like, if you have issues in your family, just go and meet Zlatan. And you have your hand.
But this song is a jam, though.
Yeah. It is a jam. But I didn't just understand the fact that you are saying yeah boyfriend, but they are calling other people's name and saying,
Yeah, boyfriend.
So I'm confused, but I mean, it's still a jam. So we're going to check it out. Number 10, Zlatan with Yeah, boyfriend. Don't be like OJ. Yeah, boyfriend.
Oh my gosh, what did OJ do to you now?
Bye bye to Yeah, boyfriend.
counseling them. Zlatan then comes back and he's dancing. And Uche is like, I
hasta la vie. Give them.
I can imagine it's a workout, eh?
Honestly. Yeah.
At number 10, Zlatan, yeah, your boyfriend, brand new entry. And the streets love it. So I had to love make it way into the countdown. Yes, and we love it. I know Amanda really, really likes that
I
song.
I do.
Yeah, I know.
Like
I know.
The first time I heard it, I was just like, bye, bye. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, sorry.
Wow. Don't worry, just move on.
Okay,
just
let's do that. All right, guys, at number 9 is another brand new entry. Yes, and it is such a vibe. Well, yeah. Okay, so it is by Rema, the loved / hated Rema. Yes, and the title of this one is Lady. The moment I see you now, I've never. It's at 1 million views on YouTube.
Crazy.
Absolute jam, and it's done well on radio, and of course,
How many days or what?
It's been a couple of weeks now. The video at least, it's been a couple of weeks now.
That's fast.
Yeah, and I really, really like the video. It's very simple, but still manages to engage you in a way, so I think it's really cool.
It's engaging, I see.
Very engaging for Jay.
We like.
Right, let's go check out number 9 video. Rema with Lady.
The moment I see you now, up that bound. Lady, oh, my lady, oh, oh. Whoa. This is your body, go boss your power, yeah.
Honestly, it's the year of the vixens.
Honestly.
Like, the people used in videos these days, there was a really loud conversation about them this year, I would say. Mm-hmm. I mean, for this video, for Rora, Ricardo Banks, for Joro, like, and there's so much fire dancing in this video as well.
Honestly.
Love it.
That girl actually looks like Arike.
She does.
Looks like this is Arike.
Yeah.
With this hair, the face, but the body is different. Even the structure itself is different.
The structure is different, but even the body, I mean, that hourglass thing going on, it's a bit of it.
Yeah. Glass.
I knew that's what she was frowning before I said that one.
Let's just move on from Arike. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, that was our number 9 song, Rema Lady. Yes, our number 8 song was actually number 7 last week, so it's dropping one spot. And of course, it's credited to Joe Boy from the Love and Light EP. Yes. This song is titled Beginning. Check this out.
Joe Boy, give it.
I've been spending all of my money on you. Spend a couple million on you. Give you love until you say you don't do it. Special type of feeling that I feel when I'm with you.
Give them.
I feel like that's the best part of that song.
Honestly, I don't think I can measure his name now without saying give them. Yes. It's just like natural now. You know, he was saying you should change his name. Maybe we should add it. Give them.
Like Willis, give them.
Honestly speaking. All right, guys, you just checked out that jam by Joe Boy with Beginning. Now moving swiftly along to the number 7 spot on the countdown. Now this one is from IVD featuring Zlatan.
Again.
And of course, Olanle is still peppering them on this spot, and it's a jam. Guys, in 7 days, Zlatan's show is going to be live. Are you excited about that?
Hasta la vie.
I'm happy for him. I'm very happy for him. And of course, we were saying last week that his mom gets to see him perform.
Yeah.
And he's stoked about that. So yeah, look, it's a first for a lot of people this season, Tenny as well. So we'll see how it goes.
Yeah.
We'll see how it goes.
I think it's going to be great. And a lot of Gbeku and what's the first one?
Zanku,
yeah. Gina, I forgot about this.
I can't keep up.
Gbeku is almost like overriding Zanku somehow.
What's the name of this one? This electric shock.
It's still Gbeku.
It's Gbeku. Yeah.
All right, guys, let's Gbeku our way to this song. This one's from IVD and Zlatan with Bolanle.
Bolanle gets his boyfriend. Where they misbehave. She gets his boyfriend. Where no like to spend them.
Give them.
Oh, dear, I'm not making it nice.
No.
Oh, you see some people doing that.
Oh, yeah, do it.
I can't do it. But I'm saying that when you see some people, but oh, dear, do you are doing that? I'm like, grandpa.
I love it. I can't do it, but I know that's not it.
Yeah. So you can do it.
But I can do it.
God bless you.
Amen.
This is OJ's new dance. Wow.
All right, guys, just check that out. Number 6 song, that number 7, rather. That was IVD featuring Zlatan with Bolanle. And to a number 6 spot, Joe Boy featuring Mayoko with Don't Call Me Back. I mean, Joe Boy, yet another appearance. I think just one song in between. That's how amazing he's doing as a talent. And I'm just excited for him. He has so many shows he's going to be performing at this December. Yeah. I saw him perform on Saturday and I was like, the love in the crowd was crazy, by the way. And, you know, just keep doing you, man. Comparisons or not, you and Fireboy, you are killing it and we love you.
Oh, you
Joe Boy featuring Mayoko with Don't Call Me Back. If I'm calling you, I don't pick up. Please don't call me back.
Mrs. Arike, you're proud.
You say you get another man. You say you know me again. The kind of prayer where I feel that day, me, I know go feel talk again.
I'm not gonna go through like this, so.
Sneak peek right there into our number five song. Can you guess what it is?
You already know. We heard the bass.
Some people don't really care for music. They can't tell. Anyway, at number five, guys, yes, Ricardo Banks with Rora. Absolute jam. There's so much to say about this. I don't think there's nothing we haven't said, or there's anything we haven't said about this song. And Ricardo also performed at Cardi B's thing.
It was good.
Did you see what he was doing? Telling his DJ, don't play my music till I tell you to play my music. And people around me were like, oh, what is Ricardo Banks doing? Just perform. And the DJ will start and he'll say, DJ, stop. Don't play my music till I tell you to play my music. And I'm like, is that a routine? We're not feeling the vibe. We're not catching that cruise. So just, we want to dance.
If only you and your DJ are in on the joke.
It's not funny.
Right, well, I'm in on this one because I love this song. Ricardo Banks, Rora, absolute jam. Absolute jam, check it out.
Yes, Ricardo Banks, number five with Rora. Yes, our number four song, ladies and gentlemen, was actually number two last week. And this one is credited to the star boy. The song is titled Juro, and it's from Wizkid. And of course, the guy that produced the song. It's dramatic. Not Boy produced the song. Wizkid said it's Killer Tunes that produced the song.
Yeah.
I don't know, but I just love the song.
But we do know it's a jam, right?
I just love the song. Number four, Wizkid, Juro. Let's go.
Every night, every day, every day, me go need my baby to call on me, close to me,
No, don't do it yourself, my love.
Until the day of performance, before it happens, our party is going down. So I'm going to give it to you guys.
Oh, wow.
I'm going to be performing live on stage.
Okay.
Arike live on stage.
I don't even see it happening. But guys, you just said that the original one by Wizkid with Juro and the original video Vixen, not Arike. We'll be simply into the countdown. We have on our third spot this one from Tekno, Skeleton. And I know that you guys were talking about how Tekno just brings like one jam, drops it and goes. But this time around, Tekno is about to drop another song on his birthday on the 17th. So I'm surprised about that. Called Suru. So I'm like, okay, maybe Tekno is back and is hotter than ever. All right, guys, we're going to check it out right now. This one is by Tekno with Skeleton. Okay. Oh my God!
I love your macaroni skin.
Honestly.
Are we back?
Yes, we are back. Okay. OJ, please don't do that dance again.
All these married people. All
right, that's step. It's Arike.
No, all these married people are not sure.
You guys just check out.
Where are they, Sha?
Wait, Skeleton.
It's Arike.
Number two spot is Tenny with Billionaire. And I really love what Tenny is doing with this her show thing. The other day on our way home, on my way home from work, I saw her on Third Mainland, and yesterday she shut down the whole of VI, distributing, the bill, hand bill, and all of that.
Come on my show, come on my show.
That's how you do PR. If you don't have money to get professionals, you do it yourself. Go out there, make your money. Number two, Tenny, Billionaire, because she wants to be a billionaire.
Tenny Makanaki.
Let's go.
I'm gonna wake up in a Lamborghini.
Speak it into existence. What's the next one? Breakfast in Santorini. All right, guys. Are you wondering why we're standing? Well, it's time to go. Sorry. But we can't do that without first letting you know what song we have at number one this week. Mm-hmm. And the number one spot this week is an absolute jam. Absolute jam. Mm. And for the third week in a row, guys, number one! Davido featuring Popcorn with Risky.
Risky, yes.
With your body Risky. Risky.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, that time right here is done and dusted. And of course, tomorrow we still have a packed show for you guys. So ladies and gentlemen, we're done. We'll catch you guys tomorrow. For myself, OJ, Foladele, Amanda, and of course, Mrs. Arike. We say be happy with yourself, and we'll see you guys tomorrow. Number one, Davido.
popcorn.
Risky.
Hey.
No, no lie. Yeah. Run am anyhow you want to run. Check out, baby girl, you fire pass it on. No doubt. No, no doubt. But you say.